think back at that lad who turned pro and his ambitions in the sport, and you know, you're still cracking on, you're still doing well, but you know, what's the difference when you're at that point now, these few years later? What, you know, you look back and reflect.
Main difference is I'm blonde now. I just want to address that before we carry on. I'm the new blonde bomber. I turned pro with Stevie Bell originally, a good friend Stevie, who I love to bits and I've got a lot of time for. If I'm honest, maybe just was a bit of a trial and error thing, just why not? Just give it a go. I wouldn't even say, it's mad to say this, but I wouldn't even say I had specific aspirations of winning titles or anything. It was just a case of take each fight as it comes and just see how I do, because I didn't have a big amateur career. It was a case of just learning on the job and trying my best. And from then, you know, I thought, I'm not bad for what I'm giving it and what I'm putting into the sport. I'm not getting too bad out of it. I'm not the worst boxer. But I wouldn't necessarily say I was going to go anywhere at that point. If you'd have asked me and I would have spoke honestly, I would have said probably wouldn't do anything. Probably would have knocked it on the head fairly early. I contemplated doing it a few times. I then thought, you know what, why don't I have a little bit of a change and move on from Stevie. It was actually his idea. He said, if you want to give boxing a good crack, maybe you should try elsewhere, because we were too good of friends almost to be training one another. So I went over to Mr. Haroon Headley at Heavy Hitters, who I was with for the next 4 years, done a lot for me. We had some mad fights together, some mad experiences. Obviously I've spoke about Bermuda. And then I really picked up some momentum then. I had 4 fights in the first year that was with Haroon. Won all 4, boxed at the MEN Arena. So obviously that was like a nice thing for a young Manchester lad to be able to say they've done.
Yeah, one more.
Obviously all the pandemic hit, lockdown, went really fat in lockdown, drank a lot of alcohol. Probably was, if I'm honest now, can say it was going to knock boxing on the head. Then Haroon had a little bit of an intervention and came over to my house one day and sat down and just said, I'm not letting you quit, which obviously now I appreciate and thank him for that. Shortly after, signed with Kevin Marie, who I think's probably one of the best things that's ever happened to me. I really got a lot of time and respect for Kev. I think he's brilliant at what he's doing. We hit it off straight away. Then got a couple of days after signing with Kev, got offered a Nathan Heaney fight. Took that on a couple of weeks' notice. I banged on and on and on about how much notice I got, and it wasn't a lot, so I won't go into how many days I had training. Jumped up a fair few weights to take the fight. A lot of people were shocked that I did so, but I believed in myself, and I knew how tough I'd become and how much I'd improved in the gym. It might not have shown in the performances because of the long layoff with the pandemic stuff, but I know that in that time after the intervention that Haroon did and what have you, I really, really improved and I toughened up a lot. My mindset changed and I thought, nah, do you know what, I'm gonna give this a go, and if someone stands in front of me, I'm gonna have it with them, and I'll fight anyone, I'll do it. And when the opportunity came, I wasn't going to turn it away, and I was fully confident that I would beat him. Didn't go my way. It was an hard fight, but I definitely showed that I'm one, tough, and I'm two, a good boxer, because I went 10 rounds for the first time ever with a much heavier lad, much more experienced lad. He had 80-odd amateur fights. I'd had nothing. And I think I just showed everyone I had something serious about me. After that, had a little bit of time off because, you know, it was a tough fight. A little bit of time out of the gym. And then tried to get back into it and I just realised, you know what, I need a change, because I'd had a great time with Haroon and I've got nothing bad to say about him. However, I felt like it just ran its course in my own mind. I didn't have that love for my training environment. Got so much time and respect for the likes of Joe Pennington, who was based out on Northside. These guys are unbelievable people and I'll forever be in debt to them. Don't want to sound cringy or cheesy, but I will be in debt to these sort of people because they've done a lot for me. We've experienced stuff together, but I needed a change. So I contacted Haroon, explained where my heart was, how I was feeling, where my head was at, and, you know, moved on. I've now come to my good friend Lucas, who has really just brought me back to life, really, if I'm honest. Totally loving training. You know, the clips that I put up on Instagram, the clips that you see, we have a proper laugh. You know, boxing's hard enough as it is. So if you can have a bit of fun with it at the same time, and you should. It's a really hard sport, as everyone who's in it knows. So Lucas has just totally got me loving it again, and I thank him so much for that. I don't think he actually gets how much it means to me. I know we banter each other and what have you, but for me to be enjoying coming to the gym each day now is huge for me, because of how I felt. I'm such a joker all the time, but deep down I was proper getting upset. I was unhappy. So I owe so much to Lucas as well, because he really has. We've been friends for a while now, and we've always got on. We've always took the piss out of each other, but we work hard. He beasts me. He really does beast me. But we really are having fun at the same time, and for as long as, you know, we are together, I'm loving it at the minute. I'm loving it.
I'm happy to hear that he's saying he's happy and he's enjoying his training. A happy fighter's a dangerous fighter, you often hear. So if he's happy, I'm happy. Do I want more? Yeah. Can he give more? Yeah. Is he doing a lot more? Yeah. Is he on the right path? Yeah. Do I believe in him? Do I think he can achieve what he needs to achieve? Yeah, most definitely. Whether that's with me or with someone else, if I can make him happy and get him in better condition for this fight, maybe his next one, absolutely amazing. He needs to be happy. He needs to be fit. He needs to live the sport outside of the gym. It seems like he's doing that. So, well done to him. Let's hope he puts on the performance that he says he will.
I'm back out in a couple of weeks. Kev's got me a run out, and we're waiting on confirmation of the definite opponent. Yeah, I've got a couple put towards us, but whoever it is, I'm looking to just put on a good boxing display, do Lucas proud, myself proud, and show my improvements, because I've improved. And I think being happy in your training, you know, definitely, if you're loving what you're doing, you're going to put more into it, you're going to pay more attention, you're going to listen more, and you're going to take more on board. And that's definitely what I've done with Lucas, because, like I say, going over it again, he really has made me start loving training again. And I can't wait to show everyone genuinely how much I've come on, and going to see a different type of Ryan, because I feel sharper. I feel like I've adjusted my style a little bit. So I've still got similar style, but we've adjusted it, and we've worked on certain things that I think already in sparring, it's coming off, and it's proving to be effective.
I wouldn't say it was Ryan's first choice that he wanted to come and ask me to train him. But what he did know is I've got an amazing facility. So we came over, and we ticked over, we got him smiling. And one thing led to the next. Lucas, why don't you lead the corner? I've got my license. Why not? I can do it. And what an opportunity for myself to get a fighter of Ryan's caliber as my first fighter. Did I expect it? Did I really want it? Maybe not, but as a friend, I've done it. Now, I'm excited for him as well as excited for myself. If he puts on the performance that he's capable of doing, it can get him to get places, and that's what I want for him.
If you get me happy, you get me doing things properly outside of the gym, because that's another thing, living life outside. Man, I can smash people if I'm at the right weight, in the right mindset, and Kev Marie picking the right fights for me, it'll be perfect. I'll definitely be able to win titles 100%. So that's what I want to do now. I want to be that funny lad and that joker, and, you know, people seem to like that side of me. But at the same time, I want to be taken seriously. I want people to know that I can definitely have a fight. I've proven that now on a good stage, on the fucking telly, on a big show. It was originally a world title undercard, Frampton and Herring. Obviously, it fell through, but I've proven I can do it now. So, you know, we can only crack on and move forward, and that's what we're going to do. And with the help of the people I've got now, Lucas, Kev Marie, me S&C people, my nutritionist, platform, performance, and what have you, we're smashing it. I'm well excited to just move forward now and give it a good go.